I am Majid Memon, a law attorney from India, practicing on criminal law as also human law and constitutional law. I have been informed about the plight of an Indian citizen, a youth from India called Anand John, who has been here in US as a fashion designer, and over the past 2 years or so, he has risen phenomenally in his work and has been acknowledged to be among the top in the fashion design industry in the United States. Now, after he was evaluated by Wall Street to a substantial or handsome sum, the trouble started following him, chasing him. In the result that there were certain complaints of alleged molestation of some aspiring models, some sexual assault, etc. And he was put behind bars. His mother and his sister were in India and they came to me and informed me about the happenings post-arrest of Anand John. And it was indeed very shocking for me, and I was rather finding it difficult to believe in the manner in which they were discussing their plight. Because they came and informed me that he is an under trial prisoner in one of the prisons in Los Angeles in America, and that he has been kept in a solitary confinement and tied up with the handcuffs and all kinds of shackles. I could not accept this on their word. And thereafter, I saw certain papers of the prosecution case, and I was also explained the facts and circumstances relating to his case, which gives a clear indication that there appears to be some kind of an undercurrent conspiracy, well-knit conspiracy hatched against him to assassinate his hard work, reputation, and put him into this kind of turmoil. I came here. Before that, I approached one of the former Supreme Court judges, a most eminent, distinguished judge of Supreme Court of India, who wrote to the External Affairs Minister Shri Pranab Mukherjee and also to the Ambassador of United States from India, and he forwarded my letter to both these gentlemen and expressed his anxiety as to whether, if this is true what is alleged, then it's a very serious matter. Now, I came down here, and for the past 1 week I have been interacting with Anand John by meeting him in prison. And I have been seeing him for the first 5 days at least, that he is being brought like an animal. He is being tied on both his arms. And when he is even talking to his attorneys, he is not able to freely move his arms, which is disgusting and which is most unbecoming of a civil society. I believe it's a universal proposition that least sense of human dignity, preservation of human right, cannot be lost sight of by any society governed by rule of law. And we believe that America is a powerful nation. United States has always been playing the role of a leader in the globe. And if they don't set a proper example of fair justice and a proper administration of justice system, I'm afraid it would be a very, very sad day. So I approached the court, I went through the papers, I interacted with the attorney, and I'm happy that after we raised some voice with regard to most unjustified behavior on the part of the prison authorities or the state, that Anand, as a state guest, as an under trial prisoner who is presumably innocent and against whom there is absolutely nothing till this day except the accusations. Now, mind you, the universal law with regard to the handling of an under trial prisoner is that an under trial prisoner who is kept confined in the four walls of prison is in fact a state guest. He is not to be condemned. He is not to be humiliated. He is not to be punished. If we do this, we are only manifesting some kind of a gross weakness in our system. So we had to raise our voice against it. And I'm happy to say that for the last 2 days, I'm finding Anand without shackles. This is at least our first victory. And I'm sure when we talk of bail, Anand has been accused of multiple accusations, which on the face of it do not inspire confidence, which on the face of it appear to be fabricated or a result of a well-knit conspiracy to put him down. And in view of the probability of his being exonerated with the passage of time being very high, you know, he should be released on bail. I understand that there is a bail order, but the amount of bail is very high. Now, this again needs some kind of a careful study with regard to criminal justice system. In any country, the law of bail has to be such that it is practical, it is availed of by a common man. Although Anand is a celebrity, but if you have offered to him bail in huge sum which is beyond his reach, even if he stretches all his financial means, then consequently such bail is literally no bail. Now, if high bail is not available to the accused in custody, defendant in custody, then that tantamounts to denial of bail. Now, why should he be denied bail? If he is denied bail, there has to be a justifiable reason recognized by established, developed law. For example, bail can be refused to a defendant if the defendant shows the tendency of fleeing from justice. If he is likely to disappear, make himself scarce, he is not entitled to be released on bail. This condition does not exist in John's case. In Anand's case, obviously, there has been no evidence worth the name to suggest that he ever attempted to flee from justice, or he doesn't have a proper place to reside, or he has no root in the society, or he is a vagabond, he may become scared, and therefore ends of justice will suffer if he is enlarged on bail. This condition doesn't exist in the case of Anand. Second condition which may prohibit bail is that if a person who is on bail misuses his liberty by repeating the offenses of this type, he could be hazardous to the society. If a person is adjudged to be hazardous to the society, he should better cool his heels in prison. But that is also not applicable in the case of Anand. Anand was, in fact, in these very cases, on bail from April to June last year. And in the period of that 2 months, he has proved beyond doubt that he has not misused his liberty, nor has he made any unsuccessful attempt even to flee. So therefore, if both these requisites are absent, there is no reason why he should not be enlarged on bail. Now, if you slap a defendant with multiple grave accusations, your fairness, your system requires him to be afforded fullest opportunity to defend his case effectively. Now, a person who is rendered immobile, kept inside the four walls of prison, is not expected to effectively defend himself. He is finding it difficult to even impart instructions to his attorney. He is finding it difficult to move out and collect such evidence which would be necessary in the best interest of justice. He should be given an opportunity to move out and pick up such evidence which would be useful in the ongoing trial. A criminal trial is always a quest for truth. The learned judge who tries a defendant is not there to only convict or acquit the defendant. He has to embark upon an exercise which would lead him to discovery of truth. So in the pursuit to get to the bottom of the truth, both the prosecution and the defense have equal duty to assist the court. Now, if you are not allowing Anand John to pick up evidence and pour it in front of the learned judge, you are obstructing the appearance of truth, which is again disservice to the cause of justice. So, aims of justice would be met if Anand is enlarged on bail, and I am sure we are now moving in right direction. I have taken upon myself as a challenging task to ensure that Anand is released on bail earlier than later. Every night that he spends in sleeplessly is wounding the very spirit of justice. And I am sure the people in the United States of America, including the people in authority, will once again consider that whether any corrective steps are required to be taken, and if so, they be taken as early as possible. Thank you very much.
Good job.